problem. My first question is, and when I was making an episode on NRCs, NRC is implemented. We've got those camps that are there. What happens after that? Nobody has been able to explain to me what happens after NRC has happened. Manliya CAB has also happened. You've put people into these camps. What happens then? I am honestly at a lack to understand that. Bangladesh has said that that's your problem, you deal with it. We are not taking back even one. What do we do then? Anybody can take this.
May I?
Yeah.
Okay. You see, BJP is trying to bring this CAB by negating the Assam Accord. You see, she was mentioning about the Assam agitation. We all know that Assam had a very tough time, that anti-foreigners agitation that took place in Assam from 79 to 85, long 6 years. Hmm. These 6 years, Assam agitation actually put Assam backwards. You know, we went backward by many years. So after a lot of consultation, the Prime Minister, that then Prime Minister, late Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, with a lot of consultation, with dialogue with the agitating parties like All Assam Students Union, Assam Accord was signed in 85, in August, 15th August 1985. Assam Accord very thoughtfully included all those people, and agitating parties also agreed to accommodate all these people who came to Assam before partition, before independence, even after partition. Mm. I must point it out that for rest of the country, see, as per Liaquat Nehru Act, or whatever, dialogue and agreement, 1951 was the kind of, cutoff,
true.
And which was covered by Citizenship Act 1955.
True.
But for Assam, when Assam Accord was concluded, and everybody agreed, it was a kind of a consensus. Even BJP agreed that time, that 25th of March 1971 would be cut off. You know, that is the Lakshman Rekha. Before that, whoever came, Hindus, Muslims, they will be accommodated, they will be part and parcel. It was a very kind of broad consensus, and everybody agreed. And Assam Accord brought in a lasting peace, in Assam, really. And after that, Assam really took off.
Sure.
But what is most unfortunate, that time the BJP agreed. When Assam Accord was signed, even BJP agreed, because by then BJP was in existence, 1985 I'm talking about. So Assam Accord was sort of panacea. Today, they are bringing this cab. I don't know what would be the modified form as they reintroduce again the Lok Sabha. Mm. But it is basically negating the Assam Accord, which is not acceptable.
Okay, so would you want to respond to that in terms of negating the accord? And also, sir, the question also is being asked as far as how constitutionally legal would it be, because would it stand the scrutiny of the Constitution or the Supreme Court, because we are differentiating on the basis of religion, which the Constitution does not allow.
As the Honorable MP was saying, when you pointed out how the outsiders were brought into Assam during CPM time, during Congress time, he said it was necessity. What had become a necessity has today become a compulsion. So how does CAB negate Assam Accord? CAB is not in its final form. We are doing the consultative committees. We are talking to people, the stakeholders. To see a ghost everywhere is a very dangerous trend in the sensitive matters. And I'm quite surprised that everyone is seeing a ghost in every cupboard. It is not that way. As I said before, there is a problem. The country was divided, that we cannot debate on that. At various points of time, people came in, the minority especially.
Agreed.
Of the neighboring companies came in at various points of time, took shelter in India. We must open our eyes to the fact.
That's
and
given.
And decide what to do.
What do we do about it?
That is
we
what
can't
the
debate CAB, history. You know, it's fact.
That is what the CAB is about. Those minority people who had come in
of a particular religion, the minority
can I come in?
Would be kicked out, and a particular religion would be allowed protection.
I am saying the minorities from East Pakistan and West Pakistan were persecuted and they came to India and they settled down here.
Correct.
Now, what is that population going to do? One has to decide.
Correct.
You cannot close your eyes and say no one came, nothing happened.
No, no. What is being debated is minority, Hindus and Muslims both came. What are we going to do now? Are we going to keep one part who were persecuted and kick out the other part who were persecuted? That is the question.
Has that decision been taken as yet?
That's the question we are debating.
Why should I assume that?
Nobody is assuming. We are asking you. What is the plan?
There are stakeholders. Let us talk to them. And we'll have to find out a way. It is a humongous problem. It is a huge
Agreed.
Problem. There is no easy way out of it. Yes or no answer. We'll do this tomorrow. We'll put 2 and 2 into 4. 2 into 10 is 20. That cannot be the equation of that.
True.
It is a long process. But we have opened our eyes to this problem.
Okay.
That is what's here.
No, Akash, I just want to intervene. What he's saying that how CAB is negating the Assam Accord. Of course, Assam Accord, date was 25th of March 1971. And this date does not discriminate either Hindu or Muslim. Whoever came, they are all part and parcel of the Indian society. But what is BJP doing? They are first thing, they are bringing a new deadline of for 2014, whatever, December or something. And they said, this will be applicable only for Hindus and non-Muslim groups. How can we accept it? You are basically attacking the constitution of India. It is totally unconstitutional, number one, and it is against the Assam Accord, that Assam Accord that brought peace to Assam. We are not acceptable.